Hello, America. This is Cool Hand saying, holy shit. I've watched some CPAC coverage. Holy moly. What's up with the Republicans? Really, what's up with them? They've gotten mean. Everything is darn terrible. They got nothing nice to say. And I noticed yesterday, Republicans voted for that bill to help all of us. Ooh, they were mad. They were really mad. I don't know why. Maybe it's because they deny Biden winning by 12 million votes. Maybe that's it. The 12 million votes. Too many brown people voting. That must be it. Their white nerves can't have over brothers and sisters vote. Yeah. And did you see the stage at CPAC? It looks like an SS person put their touch on there. It has lots of neo-Nazi symbolism on the stage. Just look it up. You'll find what I'm saying. Look. The Republicans are going nuts. Totally nuts. They've lost it. Big time. And they're willing to take all of us down the rabbit hole. They don't care. They do not care. They think that they don't have to vote on anything to help us. That we'll forget about what they just did. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm registered decline of state. And I did that for a reason. Because I don't like either party. I don't like what the Democrats do. And I sure don't like what the Republicans do. And personally, right now, the Republicans are on my shit list. You got boys? You gotta act like people. There's people hurting in this country. And it doesn't bother you. Any of you Republicans. It doesn't. Ted Cruz at CPAC made a big joke about it. Hey, Ted, this time, I think being cold, frozen, and no water and no food, the voters this time are going to throw your ass out on the street. And I hope they do. See, Texas is what the Republicans want. They want no regulation at all. See, they think, well, you know, that river in Ohio in 1968 that set a fire when someone threw a little cigarette in it. Because that's how they want the rest of the country to be. And I want to go back to that time when we have no regulations. We know what you want. That's not what people want. See, what American people want is they want to be able to turn the tap on and not die by drinking water. They want to go to the store and not die by tainted food. They want to drive down a nice road that doesn't wipe the car out. They don't want to die from baloney pills they take for some ailment they have, because there was nobody to check it. Republicans just want no regulation. They want anarchy. But personally, I don't like too much regulation either. I don't like stupid. I can't stand stupid. Like, trying to tell your kid, trying to make your kids feel sorry because they're white. That's not what we do in this country. But it's happening right now. Or trying to shame them because they're heterosexual. Hey guys, wake up! That's not your job. Leave the kiddies alone. Whoa. Whoa, what was that? Oh. Well, that's a new one. Hey, look. I'm not on social media. Won't have it. Right now, social media is not controlled right. Look what happened. We had 6 years of Trump. Trump acted like an idiot, and they threw him off finally because of the insurrection. I care about this country as much as you do. You, out there. It's both of our country. Take your finger out of your butt and do the job. Your job is to call your representatives weekly and tell them you're not happy. Or if you are happy, tell them. But do your job properly. Because the Republicans especially don't want to help you at all. If they had their way, they would have it pre-1932. That's what they'd like to have it. Oh yeah? You're destitute? Kick your head out of the house, around the curb. That's what used to be before FDR. Thank God for Franklin. My grandpappy said, you hear anybody say a bad word about Franklin Delano or Roosevelt, punch him in the mouth. Hard. He always told me Mr. Roosevelt saved his country. And he always made sure of telling me that. Has our country had some problems? You bet it does. It sure does. I've watched now for a year how Americans treat this problem we have. And they're not doing the job. They're acting like idiots. My grandmother and my aunt were nurses in 1918. They were nursing the boys coming back from World War I when the pandemic hit. The first pandemic hit and lasted 1 month and it went away. It came back in September of 1918, and it lasted till the end of February 1919. But the worst of it was the week after the armistice, because everybody broke quarantine the day World War I stopped. And a week later, people were dying. Hundreds of them, thousands of them. It was terrible. My grandmother and my aunt said, if this ever happens again, stay away from people. Actually, the governor of California mandated masks. He said, if you're not wearing a mask, $25 fine. If you're not wearing it again, throw you in jail. He meant it. And people don't know what bad is. Philadelphia had the worst. The doctors and the nurses stopped coming to help people. It got so bad, they dug burning pits in the park to burn the bodies. So listen up, America. If you think your life's shitty, you don't know what shitty is. We lost over 500,000 people this year that shouldn't have died because we had a moron as our president. Now, the moron people are in Orlando because they feel that the election was stolen. They don't care that there was an insurrection at the Capitol. Five people died. They don't care about it. Boys and girls, are you turning to a fifth column? Because if you are, there's consequences. Big, big consequences. Look, I'm trying to keep the profanity down for a reason. Because I want people to watch what I'm saying. And what I'm saying is, we're good people in this country. We care about everybody. I care about my neighbors. And I want my neighbors to care about me. I want what's good for my family and their friends and everybody in this country. I don't see blue or red shirts. I see Americans. Now, the Republicans are all pissed off. Oh, the Democrats, they're doing this and that. Come on, guys, look. You lost. And thank God you lost. You were running the country like idiots. And you still are idiots. And I can't understand. You won't change. You gotta change. It's over. There's only known voting fraud is five people. Four people in Pennsylvania. They've been prosecuted and they're going to serve time. And then there's this other person named Donald Trump, and there's a recording of it, was trying to commit voter fraud in Georgia. Yes, voter fraud. Well, if you asked most Trump Republicans, oh no, it wasn't voter fraud. And right now, Republicans in Republican-controlled states are trying to push, make it hard for people to vote, especially people of color. excuse me, call yourself patriots. You're not patriots. No, patriots wouldn't do that to other people in our country. I was taught not to look at a person's skin color. Hey, it's not so much skin color is the problem. It's the person. And I want to tell you something. There's not a place in this planet where you can get away from assholes. They're all over. You can go to a community that's really nice, and there's that one asshole you'll know, he's there. So, what are you going to do about it? Are you going to help everybody? You should. I went through my pantry last month. Got all the stuff that I haven't been using. Took it to the food bank. Went through my earthquake supplies. Took the stuff that was about to go bad in about a year. Gave it to the food bank. Put new stuff in. Help people. Do something nice. We can't allow Donald Trump to run this country ever again. Personally, Donald Jr. and all the other felons of Donald's failed empire, you will go to jail. And all those people that were pardoned by the president, you lost your Fifth Amendment rights. You can't self-incriminate anymore. Roger Stone. Look, it's our country. Ours. You, out there. Act like it. Really, act like it. You know, wake up every now and then. Grab your cell phone in the morning, say, Tuesday. Have your representative, Nancy Pelosi, Chuck Schumer's number. I mean, top people of the countries in here. While you're doing your business in the head, in the bathroom, call them. Stay involved. Because they don't like when you're involved. They really don't. They want you stupid. Sitting on your couch with your finger up your butt. That's what they really like. Okay. Well, also on this one, you can read my little thing about what I feel about the country also. This is a cool end saying, do your job, America, or somebody will do it for you, and you're not going to be happy if they do it. Bye-bye.